Hi guys, welcome to AppSense Pro. Welcome to another automation related tutorial video where I'm going to show you guys how you can connect Jira Service Management with N8N. If you don't know about N8N, N8N is an AI agent platform, basically a drag and drop platform through which you can create AI agents, chatbots, connect multiple softwares, and basically do a lot. And as we all know, we are facing an AI gold rush, so we should also learn AI and automation. And I am creating these tutorials just for you guys completely for free in order for you to learn how you can automate the task. In this tutorial, I'm going to connect Jira with N8N and I'm going to create a basic workflow in order to show you guys how you can work with Jira and N8N. If you don't know about Jira, Jira is a service management software, which is a very big software, which you can use for support system and internal software development. It's basically a super, super duper feature-rich software, which you can use completely for free. I mean, there is a paid tier available, but you can use most of the part completely for free. And if you're using Zendesk, I would suggest go with Jira if you're a small team, because it gives you a lot of features. Anyway, we're going to switch to the connection of N8N and Jira. So this is my Jira service management. I've been already using this for like many years, and we have our support team works with this. And that is my N8N, which is hosted in the Google Cloud using Docker container. If you don't know how to deploy that in Google Cloud completely for free, I already have the video for you guys. So if you go to my channel and visit the N8N playlist. So that is my channel. I'm going to go to my playlist. And this is the N8N playlist where you will find a lot of workflows which are completely for free. You don't have to sign up for any subscription or membership. All you will have to do is just go to link in that description and copy the workflow which I have created. I have created workflow for LinkedIn automation, for scraping unlimited emails from Google Maps and automating your social media. And this is a complete N8N tutorial for the beginners. And this is for generating thousands of leads completely for free. I mean, there are multiple workflows which I've created completely for free available in this playlist. And this is the video where you can learn how to install N8N completely for free using Google Cloud. And it just costs me pennies. Okay, now we will connect Jira with N8N and we will go to our N8N workflow. Click on this plus sign, search for Jira. And we want to basically trigger our N8N workflow when a new issue in Jira is created. So I'm going to click on issue created. And here I already have one of the account connected with this. So I'm going to click on this drop down and then click on create new credentials. You probably wouldn't see this. You will have it blank and you will just create new credentials. Let's click on create new credential and make sure to select the cloud. If you're using the self-hosted version, then there's a different method, which I am not covering on this video. I'm just covering the cloud version. So if you're using Jira Service Management on the cloud, this is the method to use. I'm going to use the email, which I am using as an admin of the Jira. So this is my email address, and I'm going to add an API token. Now let's generate the API token in Jira. Let's go to Jira and then click on your user icon and then click on account settings. And from here, click on security. And from here, you will see create and manage API tokens. I'm gonna click on that. And once you land on that, you will have your screen like this. Now let's click on create API token. And I am going to name my API key as N8N tutorial. You can name it whatever you want. Make sure you set the expiry date. Currently, it is set to be expired within 2 weeks, but you can extend the expiry date. I'm gonna leave it as it is for now. Let's click on create. And here we have our API token generated. I'm going to click on copy and then paste the API token here. Once the API token is pasted, I am going to add the domain name, and the domain name is this. So that is my domain name of the Jira. I'm going to copy it completely using, including HTTPS as well, and then paste it here and make sure to remove the ending slash and then click on save. And now you can see that my Jira is connected with N8N. Jira Cloud version, right? Now, let's test the step. Now it is going to give me the details of the issue created whenever a new issue is created. So let's click on test the step. And then I'm going to go to my Jira and then go to my project and then try to create a new Jira issue, which I can create in here. So I'm going to go to tickets and then click on this blue color create button. And I am now creating a new issue, right? Let's name it testing N8N and testing N8N. Click on create. And my issue is created. And now when I go to my N8N, you can see that it is now working and that is the output. Now it is going to give me all of the details. So that is the display name of the person who created the issue, as you can see here. And this is the issue key, which is ticket 1098. If I go to this work item or issue, which I have created, you can see I have this ticket 1098 showing up here as well. See ticket 1098. And it will also display all of the other details as well, like description, title, and all of the stuff. Where it is. So a lot of data is coming through that event, and you can have it set up for any of the event. The issue created is just one example. You can do that for a new comment created within the Jira issue, or comment updated, or issue created, or issue update. I mean, there are a lot of events which you can use for the Jira trigger and to run this workflow. Trigger is basically, it is going to run the workflow when this happens. And I have created a similar workflow for creating a new customer when I get a new email, creating a new issue when a new issue is created in my Jira project. And that is my workflow, which I have been using, and it is working really good. Now, the first node is for the Jira trigger. By the way, I'm going to give you guys this workflow completely or free in my channel. All you have to do is just click on the link in the description and you'll be able to copy the workflow. This workflow is basically going to see when a new Jira issue is created. It is going to check if it is created from the owner. So I am currently testing it here. So this is the if condition after the issue created. It is going to check that this should be the email. If this condition is true, it is going to basically add the issue description and then run the code. And it is going to extract the name, email, and website URL from that email. And then it is going to create a new customer using this HTTP request node. By the way, you cannot create a new customer in Jira node, in N8N node. So if you try to find out this in N8N node, you won't be able to create a new customer. There is no option to create a new customer. That is why I have this HTTP request node in order to create a new customer. So this is the complete details. You will select the credential type and basically select the same credential, which I have just shown you guys how to connect. And we will be sending header. And then we are sending the body, display name, and email. So this is the type of email which I get whenever someone fills up a form on my website. And I don't just receive the email. I have pointed it to Jira. So you can see that help@websensepro.atlassian.net. So it is also going to create an issue in my Jira. And then my team will communicate using Jira. But the problem with that flow is that each time the new issue was created, my team member had to manually create a new customer in Jira, which is a hectic task. You will have to click on customers, open the customers in a new tab, and then click on add. Like I would do like add customer, add in the name, email, and then assign that task, assign that issue to that specific customer. So that was all of the manual process which we were doing whenever a new issue was created in Jira. But this workflow has automated that. So it is going to record whenever a new issue is created in Jira. It is going to check in this if condition node that whether if it is coming from this email, right? If the condition is true, it is going to then process with the remaining workflow, which is basically going to read the request. So it is going to set this field description and that we are code node from all of the detail of the Jira issue. It is going to extract name, email, and then website URL. That's what the code node does. And then it is going to create HTTP post request to Jira to this customer API endpoint, where it will automatically create a new customer. And then this is another node. It will assign that Jira issue to that new customer which is created. So all of this manual process where we were creating a new customer and assigning the reporter to that specific customer which we created, all of that manual task has been automated using this one single workflow. So that's how powerful N8N is. Now, most of you who know about Jira Service Management will tell me in the comments that Jira is a powerful software. They do have their automation. Yes, they do have this type of automations and you can automate that using that as well, but it is very complicated. You have to learn Jira query language and there is a lot of stuff in the automation section of Jira. So that's the easy workaround in order to create a new customer and then assign that issue to the new customer which you created. I've already attached the link in the description where you can download this workflow if you want to automatically create a new customer and then assign that issue to the new customer. And that's it for the video, guys. I hope that was understandable. And let me know in the comments below if you need more clarification or if you need more understanding about Jira or N8N. And if you want us to create custom workflows, custom AI automations, let us know. We have a link in the description. You can simply fill up the form and we'll be able to assist you with creating custom workflows and automations, AI agents, chatbots, you name it, we can do it. Until next video, have a great day.